skin.
Yeah, more skin. But cabbage is, I think, fast. And water.
No coach?
No, yeah.
No coach? No last minute coach?
I don't know.
So they're saying that maybe yes?
Maybe yes.
Yeah, maybe yes. Yeah. That is better.
Yeah.
So we know him. Blue, white?
Blue.
White?
Yes.
Serve. Side. 2 minutes.
Final. Rajat Kubli, Shan Kong, Shan, Sir, 0-0.
Hey, come on.
Here we go, 2500 final. First prize, $700. Second prize, $350. Tong Zhang to serve. This should be an interesting match. You have the power of Tong Zhang against the control of Rajat. Rajat has a good control. He has some good serves. And that inside-out loop he can block with his backhand. Doesn't play like regular table tennis. Plays old school. His forehand, especially when it goes to the inside-out, is very strong. But anything straight or hooked, he tends to lose a little bit of consistency. 2-1. He's got a vicious backhand serve. Oh, nice push. Nice opening to the forehand. I would say this match, Barbara is going to be, Tong is going to try to, if he knows what he's doing, is go after that forehand and loop into that forehand of Rajat. Rajat's backhand block and inside, anything from the backhand side, he's strong. Not on that one, though.
Not on that one.
Well, he went straight down the line. That makes a little bit of a difference because it's coming in, but he likes to take that ball cross court with his forehand. But they're just feeling each other out. I'm sure this is the first time they've ever played. Nice return of serve.
Zhang Tong gives a great, just difficult but still long push, and we saw that give Ernesto trouble in the last match.
Hey, on, hey.
Six, three.
several errors by Rajat.
Come on, two.
What was it, 3-0 and then 6-3? I think it was.
Yeah. Tong is the master of string of points.
Wow. And that was one explosive loop there. That thing hit his racket and it exploded. Exploded with topspin. That's what you're looking for on your forehand. Get that high rotation and then you'll get a lot of variation.
Misread of that serve.
Got a nice little backhand serve. And he'll turn and spin it cross court with his forehand.
Uh-oh. Oh.
I gave him the jinx. Nice backhand serve. And he missed that a couple times against me, too. He fakes side spin in and tries to go topspin fast. Takes his eye off the ball. Took it off a couple times against me. But he won the two close games and moved on to the final.
Struggling with that one.
Tong is one cool customer. I mean, as we saw in that semifinal, I mean, he was never flustered. He was in big trouble, down 4-0, then 5-0, and he just, ever since then, look at this game.
Out.
Yeah, this game. You see that forehand windmill loop there? That was a windmill loop.
Wow. There it is.
Wow, wasn't it 3-0, and then 11-4?
Master of the string of points.
I have to say that I don't know if it's the plastic ball or what, but the string of points that I've noticed throughout this tournament, even against myself. I mean, I was up 7-0 and lost the game. I was up 10-6, lost the game. I heard someone just now was up 10-4 and lost. It's a string of points. Like right there, up 3-0, lose 11-4. Or, you know, Tong being down 5-0, win 11-7.
Yeah.
11-6 even. I think it was
6.
Might have been 6. Might have been 7, that semi. Yeah, it was 7. 11-7. But still, that was 10-2.
Yeah, exactly. After losing the first 5.
Yeah, 11-2. And Rajat needs to regroup. He's a fighter.
Jontel is a cool cucumber.
Yeah, he's always thinking, but he's one of those guys that you know he's always thinking, but he's not showing you anything. He's not giving away any emotion, nothing.
And he's pretty clutch player, as we found out this year in the collegiate final.
2500 final, folks. Here we start. Side topspin serve. Nice backhand to backhand. If anything, Tong's backhand in the counter gets a little bit early, reaches for it. That's the one problem on your backhand. When you go to hit it, you go a little early, you reach, and then you can't follow through properly. I do it all the time.
Topspin serve. Wow.
Boy, that big loop. And young legs and big loop, it's a good combination.
One.
Right now, out in the 50 tables out there, I think they're playing the 2400.
Hey.
So all the tables pretty much active here at the Badger Open.
Wow, another huge forehand.
And Rajat's having trouble with the service, not keeping it down and not doing much with it. When you play Tong, there's one rule of thumb. You gotta not let him hit too many big forehands. If you do that, you can win. But that's just so you know what your goal will be. You fight all the time to not let him have that.
Just like, and that backhand block is good from Rajat. So if he gets a nice little softer loop, he can really play out this rally.
That was a beauty. That was a second block. First block pretty good. Second block beautiful.
Really good.
Yeah, I ripped some big loops into his backhand, but it was right into his backhand. He brought it back, no problem. Ball placement. I should loop him to the middle.
Topspin. Oh, he didn't get around fast enough.
Yeah, and Rajat doesn't have a backhand loop, so that means that's old school right there.
That is.
I don't have a backhand loop. Old school. You know, back in the day, you know, the rubber wasn't so good. Very difficult to backhand loop. We just pushed and countered and hit. Here we go.
Jontel ready to loop kill that.
Yeah, Rajat's just not getting off the mark, but it's early. But it doesn't look like a good fit for him. For some reason, this match doesn't look right. Like, he can't get into the blocking. And
the big forehand, the third ball, haven't seen a lot of those.
It's too big that he can't get into his feeling where he can block and move the ball around.
Right there again.
Yesterday, Ruchao Chin fought back to win the $2,000 open prize against Jishan Liang in what was one of the better finals of the year. If you have a chance, watch that, especially, you know, game six when the whole thing turns around. You know, on ESPN they have like classic football games or ESPN Classic. They should have classic table tennis matches. You know, the one, you know, not too many of them, but only ones that are like that. Something that you know when you watch it, it's going to be good.
That's right.
That would be neat, you know. And they'd have to be current too, because otherwise, you know, you don't really watch old stuff.
You can't learn as much from the old stuff. Right. The sport's changing so quickly. Right, Rajat doesn't look in his element in this match.
Yeah, it doesn't look good, but it's still early. But Tong, he's got kind of the game to just shut him down.
Wow.
There's the good blocking.
Side? Edge?
7-4.
Taking that as an edge.
Take that as an edge. I'll tell you, that was really close.
Yeah.
I don't know. Actually, Rajat, that was pretty nice of him because the ball certainly didn't go up.
It didn't go down
either. Didn't go up, didn't go down. It was one of those, I'm not sure. That was a big point too, 6-4, 6-5. Yep, there's that.
Forehand, the first miss for in a while.
Yeah, a little more underspin, the ball is a little short. And then that unforgiving net, when you hit that top of the net with your loop, it'll just pop off the under the table pretty much 8 out of 9 out of 10 times.
7-5. Hey, come on, let it go.
Harris to go and serve and short to Tong's forehand. Might give him a little angle to get that big whip forehand loop. He really does whip that loop. He hasn't been able to use it so far. That was the first good one, but we've seen throughout the tournament. He made the semis of the Open also, so he's a player. There's a good spot. He'll get that forehand in. See?
There we go.
That ball's heavy. See, now this is table tennis at its best, just to find a nice little technique, and all of a sudden you can see he's got a little confidence.
And everything can turn around until someone else makes a little adjustment.
And we have Mr. Cool in the yellow, and then we have Emotion in the black and purple or whatever. Something like that.
Go. Eight all.
Go ahead!
Looks like Rajat's found a little niche.
Allez, go! Allez!
Oh, short to the forehand is working.
Big four, yes. That's the technique that's
working.
And I think it'll work the rest of the match. I should maybe change it up a little, but if Tong doesn't flip that ball, he's going to get that big forehand in, and that's a really strange spin.
Ali, go! 8-10. Ali!
Tong's going to try to do two of these serve attacks to stay in the game.
That wasn't a bad return. He kind of flipped it a little slow, but Tong was ready. We've seen that he's really great anticipating that attack and a counterattack.
Right off the top of the net.
Yeah, it's a game. It's a big game there. Rajat's in the match now. We got a match, folks, for the 2500 finals.
Oh.
on the other 50 plus tables here at the 2015 Badger Open. We're looking at the under 2400s, the under 2200s, doubles under 3800, under 14 in age, over 40, and a bunch of other events, including Hardbat, which will take place today when the on the third day of play and the last day at the 2015 Butterfly Badger Open. Getting ready to enter game three, a big game in this best of five match. Well, beautiful rally by Zhang Tong and Rajat. They both played really well there. And starting the point out a little slowly, a little feeling each other out, and then Zhang Tong's big step around forehand.
Ali, go! Come on!
Nice long serve, surprising Rajat.
Zero, two. There you go. Yo!
That little backhand serve causing trouble. Rajat's not serving short to the forehand, but I would have expected more of in game three. It worked in game two. Chantal looking for a block there instead of a big counter loop. And Rajat gaining a lot of energy in game three.
Hey.
Well, big error there, missing the serve. The momentum certainly changed.
Zhang Tong picking up that one.
Hey, go.
Three, 2500 final in the Badger Open. It's been growing every year, and now they got a facility where I think they can handle the growth, and 248 hey, players this year, as it's starting to come to a close.
Oh, look at that blocking.
That was a nice side spin block.
From away from the table.
And once Rajat starts blocking well, the looper sometimes overhits a little bit. You know he's blocking, it's coming back. When I would loop at him, and I know it's coming back, and I wouldn't finish my stroke.
Yeah, because you're so worried about the next one. Mm-hmm.
But his forehand's still a little inconsistent, especially from the right side of the table. Big opening there. Rajat tried to change its direction. It's always tempting to take that big loop cross court down the line with the block.
Sometimes
but,
it's so hard.
It's hard because you're changing direction and you're also going to the shortest distance. So it's a double whammy that you got to take care of. There's that heavy under. And we talked about that all this weekend about how important the heavy under serve is because it handcuffs it's the hardest serve to really attack when it's over the table.
Go.
Rajat had the momentum, but now Tong is taking it back. There, that's what we were waiting for. That's what you do. You want to win the championship, you got to take some risks. That's what Arnold Palmer says. You want to hold the cup up high?
Hey.
If you do everything that the other guys do, you're not going to be doing it. And Tong has shown us that he is one shot maker.
He really is. And he seems to have no hesitation.
Right, that's why when you play him, your first ball has to be quality, because he's already in that counter loop look.
7-5.
Critical third game here. And a best of five.
Eight,
a little bit early on the second backhand. Like I said, when you get a little early, you can't follow through.
Oh, beautiful.
That was. That second block had like a hook to it.
And just pounded it, too.
There was a lot of topspin. Yeah, he turned that over nice. And momentum change back to the man in yellow. Right now, he looks like the winner.
I didn't quite get around fast enough.
Tong puts his finger to his head there saying, come on, I gotta think. I like that about him, and you can tell that he's constantly in the thinking mode.
Yo! Oh boy, that wrist didn't pay off.
No, that one was shaky. That one was shaky. It was heavy under. Big series right here, 9-7, two serves.
Oh.
Does he get to 10-8 or can he close it right out?
Or could it be 9-9?
Got it!
No, 9-8, three in a row.
9-8.
That was a good block there, pinned him in the backhand, and the opening was not that good quality, not a lot of spin. He's a little bit late with that ball.
Important serve right here.
Serve something long.
It's worked. Long toss has worked against Rajat into the back end. Uh-oh.
Got it!
Nine all.
Four in a row.
Four.
The momentum is just moving back and forth here.
Nine, nine.
It's ping pong. Back and forth. Da, 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 da.
What do you think Rajat's going to do?
I have no idea. I already gave the whammy when I said Tong had him 9-5 and said he's looking good. So I can do the double whammy and say Rajat will probably do this and it'll whammy him right back.
Hey.
All right, 9-9, crucial point of the match. Absolutely.
Very, very crucial.
Wow, a net and then a no bouncer. First one was a little bit late and he got lucky to lift it and hit the top of the net. And the second one, the ball kept some side spin or something because it did not bounce on that second backhand.
Rajat has the right strategy if you pin Jonathan on that backhand. Make you have an easier time.
Serve short to the forehand. Yep. Inside out to the backhand.
Oh, the Tong's right there to pound it.
He looked exactly to the backhand. He couldn't have put it better. It was just like right there. You know, that's when you think, well, why couldn't I have moved it maybe 6 inches to the left?
Right, and this is much harder.
You know, that's the difference between, you know, world-class players. When world-class players play, they automatically, their brain connects to where that ball's supposed to go.
In relation to where your opponent is standing and what they're used to.
And they've been doing it ever since young with good coaches. And that was something I remember when Jimmy Butler was like number 90 in the world and looked like he was going to go to the top, maybe even top 40 or 30, because he had the best serves almost in the world. And but his ball placement wasn't that great. And we worked on it. And Coach Lee Chen Shi, I said, you know, Jimmy could make it all the way top. And he told me, he says, I don't know. He says, ball placement has to come from young. You must. Aww. It's like it has to be ingrained into your whole for years that. And you're like, if you ever watch Ma Long and those guys, they never put the ball in the
right
place.
Right.
It's always in the center when it's weak or it's wide when it needs to be. You know, if you ever would analyze it. And that does make some sense. If you did it from, like, say, 6 years old until you're, like, 22, you would automatically go to those spots. Like, right there, you wouldn't do what he just did.
Right.
And even myself, you know, I constantly loop to the other guy's backhand right perfect. You know, if I didn't know about ball placement until I was in my 20s, you know? We just hit the ball and
went for it.
Yeah, I didn't know anything. Here we go. Rajat with it. Oh. Stop.
Stop. Net surf.
I think he was still talking before the surf, so he wanted to wait until he finished his 0-0. It was 0. And Tong says, man, I ripped that. It was mine.
The cool refocus.
The cool customer got a little bit uncool there for a moment. Yeah.
Long is tough.
That was a good return, but no bounce.
I also nicked the top of the net.
Yep.
Hey, go.
Ooh, double bounce.
Wow. Yeah, I don't like that serve. I mean, he really should just move to the middle of the table and serve short into the forehand, because then Tong will give you a weak ball. It looks like he tore his rubber there a little bit, but just on the edge. And nice he checked with the umpire.
That is very nice.
Yeah. You'd hate to go to your second racket. Yeah. I wouldn't say. Here we go. Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow. And that's what we're talking about, ball placement.
There's the big loop, and he really could have put that almost anywhere.
Yeah,
I mean,
yeah.
Down the middle, certainly. But right to the backhand, and Rajat's backhand is very nice on the block. Good return of serve. A little side top, and Rajat just pushed it forward. Didn't push it. Just turned it over. When you turn it over soft like that, the side spin will stay on, and the first bounce may be a little erratic to the side.
Hey.
Rajat's getting pumped up. Oh, yeah, he's getting pumped up. That was a nice little serve, I would say. A little back and over, and Jorge let that one go. He does that one occasionally. That one was fine.
That's fine.
Well, it's always fine when you do the pendulum.
Right.
It's when you do the hook. Yeah. I was just, when I was coach U.S. team, I'd tell umpires over and over, on the one serve it doesn't matter, on the other serve it does. And they would be like, I don't know what you're talking about. Because they don't know what I was talking about.
Two, five.
So what happens, the guy will throw the ball into the racket, and they'll see me complaining. So then the guy will switch to the pendulum, and the umpire will look at me like, well, what's wrong with that one? Because you don't throw the ball into your racket when you do
pendulum.
The pendulum.
No
you don't.
Way.
And this
you go.
Series of errors by Tom.
Two
shaking his head. He looks a little flustered, and Rajat
capitalizing on this opportunity.
Oh boy, that's a shaky serve there, going backward a little bit. But Tong handles it with the backhand loop. More drama, I suppose. We could have a fifth game, and that's just par for the course for the weekend.
Exactly.
Uh-oh. Two balls. No spin serve, and then Tong let it fall. It went a little bit off the side of the table. He was able to spin it from down low. Remember, when you return serve, don't rush. Try to use up the time that you have to, one, make your decision, and two, to move your feet, and three, to get ready to make the shot. That's what I'm always – I don't return serve very well these days, but that's my plan. You know, you have so much time, and you need to use it. But three in a row by Tong.
Put him right back into the game. 6-5.
Looks like the ball got a little dented or something. But right back in the game, or the ball cracked. The ball cracked during the point. Rajat's not sure.
You don't replay the point when the ball is broken. You don't replay the point when the ball is broken.
The ball cracked at the end, but it seemed to me, though, it was well after.
Yeah.
I mean, if the ball... Yeah, I don't know. That's a pretty tough call. Rajat's going to take a timeout. Somehow they both cracked in the end. I don't know. It's a tough call. Guess the umpire's got it right, though.
Galvin, Ed, the referee, confirmed. Hero back from the timeout.
Timeout and a new shirt. There you go. That's something special. I never saw anybody change during a timeout. Broken ball, new shirt. Geez, we got a lot of stuff going on here. That ball looks shaky there. Okay. They're ready, folks. We got the bright yellow against the bright green.
Look at that forehand. Tom. No hesitation.
Beautiful loop. He was a little late getting there, but he spun it, got that ball up in the air just enough.
From 6-2 to 6-6. Tong, quite the comeback.
Yes, sir. Just every game's been like that.
Come on. Go.
Going for the side top backhand serve. Let's see.
Yep.
For sure. Side top. Yep. Nice little dig on that one. He was digging it to make sure it doesn't pop up so much. He might change direction.
Might go long.
No, he's going there. He's going to get the opening for sure. Rajat in big trouble. Not so strong away from the court. It's more he has to be at the table to use his block and his inside spin. Five in a row from the man from Mississippi. The man who saved the national team championship for the college last year with a big re-loop against Texas Wesleyan. Oh,
there it goes. Nice change by Tong Tong. Not a huge loop.
Nice high and spinny, and it was pretty deep. That's the, you know, when you loop, you want that ball deep. Bounding forward, deep.
Ali, go. Come on, Ali.
Oh, wow.
It's not over.
Never over until never it's over. Actually over.
Sometimes it is. In my age, you know, sometimes it's over, but this one's definitely not.
Allez, go. Come on. Hey.
Two pretty good fighters. You don't get to the 2500 final without it. There's a lot of players in there. Hey. I think there's about 40 in it. Here we go.
Oh,
side under,
Steve.
That hurts when you come in and you drop it in the net and you feel like a louse. Because you're like, geez, I can't even return an underspin serve.
There you go.
But he was trying to drop it short. He's going side top for sure. I'd go side under, though. He'd have a little better loop.
Oh, be careful.
I knew he misses that all the time. He missed that against me like two or three times.
Wow. Sometimes big risk doesn't pay off.
Yeah, he could have went side under, I think, and he would have got a much better loop. Oh, that's the match, probably.
Yeah, I think so.
It is. That's it.
That's
Tong Zong, the $700 winner.
From Mississippi College.
Very good, and the crowd is going wild in the Badger Open. Hey, standing ovation here. Sorry. Couldn't resist that. Everyone is playing, and we don't have many spectators, but it was still a dang good match.
And Tong Tong will go home with $700, actually out-earning both of his teammates from yesterday.
And he sits like he's over there. He doesn't even look happy. They're like, oh, yeah, geez.
Oh, yes, I'm done for today.
Yeah. He's so stoic. Look at him. I mean, I'd be like, you know, hey, shaking hands with somebody. He's over sitting in a chair like, oh, well, actually, they both are, but Rajat.
That's true.
Yeah, I mean, hopefully he's enjoying it, but you don't do all that practice for nothing.
That's right, and they're looking forward to a big season this year, trying to repeat from last year.
And we're not done here. The 2400 is going on now, so they're doing the qualifiers. All the round robins are out, and that should be some high-quality match, and it might take a little while to get to the court one, but it won't be long. So we have 2400 finals and 2400 quarters and stuff like that. We'll have some matches. But it looks like a little break for now.
Until we come back. Until we'll take our time off and we'll bring you back the next matches on Table 1 when they happen.
Okay, should be 20, 30 minutes, I would think, they start that single elimination 2400 and the quarters. Okay,
great.
how great it is. Thank you.
finish the game because we didn't force it. But not in the middle.
And so the
and the tower, you just put the tower.
So that's what
that's for.
Got it. I'm going to go get a coach.
Okay. Question. Do you have coach?
What?
Do you have coach?
Yeah, I don't.
The guy who's announcing?
Are you gonna be coach? Okay, I need that here. Colors, blue and white. Who wants to choose? Blue, white, silver. Is it to side?
What do you want to do? I'll serve.
You serve. Side.
Side.
Okay. 2 minutes of warming up. Okay.
There we go. We're back on at the Badger Open, and this is going to be the 1600 final. And I think you'll find it pretty interesting. He's got Aaron Heller in the red. Is a defensive player, I think. I remember seeing him this morning. And if he does, in the blue is one of my students from South Bend. It just started playing almost only less than a year almost. He won the 1800 yesterday, and this is the 1600. And so he's a pretty big favorite, and this is only his third tournament. Playing my grip, and that's what he likes playing that way, and he has someone who can actually teach him that. It's kind of nice to be unique if you do it right. So Marty Stoner is 12 years old, and Aaron, 1600 final.
I got to pull him out during the game. Make him more nervous.
We just saw a great match between Marty and Daniel Tran, Michael Tran's younger brother. They went 5 games, and the rallies were spectacular. And not a lot of spin, but they were running all over the court, and Daniel Tran pulled it out in 5. And he was like so happy that he beat Marty, because Marty's been sort of one of the highlights of this tournament, kind of. And we'll see. Can he win the 1600? And he's actually in the 1500 too, and he's been kind of cruising in that, and he almost should take him out of that. Just a little too strong, but it's only his third tournament, so he does have trouble when he plays some long pips guys a little bit, but we'll see. 1600 final starting in just a second. Pretty long warm-up. Marty's the kind of kid he's been talking about strategy, even last night at 11 p.m. saying, yeah, this one guy was trying to trick me, but I tricked him back, and I just had to change the pace on the ball. And he was telling Dion, and he had to go a little more forward with his loop. That's one of our other students, so he's kind of already interested in the technique of the game. So we'll see. Aaron gets a lot of balls back. I watched him warm up this morning. One apiece. He's got that backhand serve, the whip across the elbow. Oh, he's not used to an umpire. And he doesn't throw it up as much, so he's gonna see, he'll get that ball up now. There you go. No problem. It actually makes the serve better. Get that ball up a little bit, you get a little bit having the ball fall down a little bit. He'd lose a point there somehow. 2-2. Marty has a forehand that's definitely repeating, and it repeats very well, very little movement in it, and he's consistent. Still having a little trouble with his pushes, but I think Aaron's going to have a lot of trouble once Marty gets hit that forehand into his backhand. I don't see Aaron really being able to do much. He doesn't have any offense, doesn't seem like. There's that top spin by Marty. That's a big spin there. Just ate Aaron alive on that one. 6-2, 2-6. You have these young kids that get so much better so quickly sometimes, but it's the mark of a champion sometimes, so you can't take that away from them. It's important to win at all levels. That's how you learn to feel like you're special. Okay, 7-4. On table 2, we got a nice match. Daniel Tran is over here playing. Not very tall, and quickly, a few errors by Marty. It shows a little bit of inexperience. 5-7. Oh, that'll kill you there. 5-8. That's a heavy ball. Long pips. Marty knows to lift that, but that's still, even when you know it, sometimes it's not enough. Oh. Problem with defensive players, they have to somehow make sure that the offensive guy doesn't get such a strong first ball. Because that right away kills you. Oh, that hit the edge. floated right in there. 7-9. Big first game. He's going to have to lift that one. Lift that one again. Oh, no problem.
7-10.
First game to Marty Stoner. Fairly easy, couple mistakes in the middle of the game. He's not being as aggressive, but I think he's just playing solid. He's going to come over to one of our students, Deion Miller. Deion Payne Miller's playing really well this tournament. South Bend, we brought 7 juniors to the tournament. Like 12 people in all to this tournament here. We've kind of had a resurgence of our junior program in South Bend. As you know, in South Bend, we had Zinski and A.J. Brewer and Jared Lynch and Joey Cochran. And then for a while, we haven't had too much. Our junior program really suffered. We had about 3 generations really good, and then we've had like a 2 or 3 year period where we lost our way. But we're back now, and we've got about 8 or 9 kids that are playing pretty serious. And we've got a couple of them that are playing my style, and they're doing really well. And that's kind of normal. The lower levels, that anti really gives a lot of problems. Let's see if Marty gets a little bit more aggressive, but not on that serve. As he didn't even throw that one up. That could have been a fault. There you go. He's not used to throwing it up so high. But a nice easy forehand topspin. His grip's a little bit too Western for me. We're going to try to keep working on moving it back to as much shake hand as we can. But it gives him a dynamic loop, that's for sure. That what that does is that grip Western gets that wrist, the ability to use the wrist a little bit more. But it certainly hurts him when he switches forehand to backhand. His forehand here, he pretty much never misses that. You can see how he already made an adjustment from the first game as to how to handle these pips and make sure the first bow he doesn't miss. There's a little hop on that one. So 2-4, Aaron so far has shown no offense. That's going to be, you know, kind of hard to win. Got to have some offense, don't you? He's getting the ball back, but Marty's not going to miss that. Marty's a tennis player. He's on the cross country, runs cross country, plays some tennis. And he's got a good overhead. So you put the ball up high, he's going to have a, he doesn't miss those very often. 2-5. 1600 final. I kind of feel sorry for the 1500 guys. Aaron's got to get that ball down a little bit with those long pips. I mean, that ball's getting up way too high. Way too high. Every ball's going up, up. Come on, make an adjustment. Hit it down lower. If you have trouble bringing the ball down, change where you're aiming. There's an offensive shot. Much better. Go for that, Aaron. Move your feet. Use that forehand a little. 8-2. That's pretty impressive, Marty. Steady. Not doing too much, but every once in a while showing a flash of that nice forehand that's pretty much, I wouldn't say automatic, but it's pretty close to that. Use the anti there, which makes an easy opening. Sometimes when you use the anti, it makes no spin on the ball, and that forehand is very easy. 10-2. 11-2. 2-0 from South Bend's Marty Stona. Aaron Heller's thinking this kid's underrated. He's probably at least 1,800. You might say he's almost probably 1,900, but it's only his third tournament. His first one, he didn't play many events, got kind of a low rating, and then he jumped up about 700-800 points, and then this is his third one. Or maybe he played one other one, but that only a couple tournaments, so after this tournament, he's going to be pretty sky high, so might get a little humbled at his next tournament, because once you get up to the higher levels, the anti may not work as well. You have to be quicker, but we also have some other juniors that are pretty darn good, too, that push Marty, and that's the best way when they get pushed in their own club. It's how you develop. Nice. Oh, nice try there. Nice little drop shot. He was going to just drop it. Come on, Aaron. Let's see some offense because this doesn't work. Oh, that works, but it doesn't work. His first lead of the match, except for early in game one, I think. He's having trouble with that serve, too. And Marty with a couple errors. Aaron's back into it. Yeah,
Four-zero
for Aaron. He gets off the snide there from game two. But can he hold it and win a game? Nice chop serve. Good poke with the long pips. Here comes that high ball. Marty had missed a couple of these. Oh yeah, that's coming back. If Aaron could just bring that down about 6 inches, it would be a lot more questionable to make that shot. It's just up there at eye level for Marty. Those aren't easy to hit, but there, that's that one. Marty's been missing that one. That was good, though. He tried to go forward and put some. You serve that underspin to the long pips, you get that little pop topspin, and you can drive that ball. Net ball, big loop. So far, Aaron's made one attack in three games, but long pips are sort of an attack, but yeah, there's no spin on that. And it's coming back. It's coming back. Oh, he switches to that forehand. You got to keep your feet moving. Sometimes you watch the flight of the ball, and then your feet stop. Don't we all know that? 5-4. Aaron's lead has gone away. There's the anti-spin, but didn't work this time. 4-6. Oh, nice. Sort of like an exhibition of height. Oh, there's a good ball. Marty's having a lot of trouble with that. Might have to put down the headphones and go out there and coach him. Oh, that's a nice topspin in the corner. Miss hit. 7-7, and we're coming maybe to the close of the 1600. Yeah, Marty's got that one. When they're a little bit high and not much spin on it, he's going to make that every time. Sometimes that spin will get him. This one here, we go to the forehand. There's a nice forehand by Aaron. That's nice to use the forehand a little bit, give it a little different ball. 8 each. Big loop. Another good one. Smash, and it's out of the court. Two match points for the 12-year-old from South Bend. And there's that ball. He's missed that 4 or 5 times. He knows what he's doing on that one. But the ball just get a little bit of hop, and here we go. Second match point. Oh, to the middle. He's got that one, and that should do it, folks. In the under 1600 final, Aaron Heller and Marty Stoner. Marty wins two events. The 1600 and the 1800, and I think in about 10 minutes they start the 1500, which I think he already qualified out of his group. All right, folks, well, this will pretty well, I don't think we have any more live streaming, but the Butterfly Badger Open to close with, you know, 248 players. Jishan Liang and Ru Chao Chen, the top players in the Open, gave a tremendous final yesterday. It was one to watch. We watch that. If you watch game 7 or game 6, actually, if you watch the whole thing, the back and forth, in no way. They fought hard. They played good quality. It's just tremendous final. And then Tong Zhang won the 2500, came back from 5-0 against Ernest Ebouin in the semifinal in the fifth game. And a lot of great matches throughout all the different events. So thanks to Butterfly and to the Milwaukee Table Tennis, Linda Leaf. And for all the players who attended this tournament. If you like a tournament, this is just a little bit north of Chicago, about 45 minutes. Put it on your schedule, third week of September every year. Butterfly Badger Open. We'll talk to you soon. Dan Seemler signing off. I'm going to go out and coach my students out there in the 1700, I think, quarterfinals. Talk to you soon.